with, you will pay for it.
Yes, amen.
And I was nudged before I even started that song, but I'm forever getting up. I always have a reason for not doing something. I've always got a reason. I can rationalize things very well.
Yes.
And that was part of my rationalization. But his brother Rico was talking about Jesus being the rock.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we are. We're building our house on the rock,
yes,
and that rock is the revelation that the Bible gives us concerning the Word of God. That's what it is. It's the revelation of the Word of God that's enlightening to your heart and to my heart.
Thank you, Lord.
And if we don't abide in what we have, then I will lose what I have. I love the Lord. I'm glad to be here. I was up at 2:30 this morning, and I've been studying. There is nothing like the Word of God. I'm telling you, you start in one area and you go to something else. And I've got one of these books here that I wrote notes all night long. Well, from 2:30 on. I finally laid down around 5:15 is what time I laid down. But anyway, it doesn't matter about that. But how good is the Word of God?
Amen.
And the Scripture says to taste of Him and see that He's good. And we are to find the old ways and the old path. And the only way that I can do that is to open that book. And as I am studying, I have all kind of books around me and help. And one of the nicest helps I have now is that little telephone that you can just do some stuff on it, and you can bring up things that will... It will enhance your study.
Yes,
it's what it
does.
It enhances what you are studying. And how good it is to feel the Spirit of the Lord.
Amen.
Knowing that we're built on the rock, Brother Rico, or the revelation of Jesus Christ, Him being the chief cornerstone.
Yes.
There ain't no more cornerstones.
No.
There is not another way to go.
Mm-mm.
There's only one way to go. He's a one-way Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
I believe it was Sister Keno that used to sing that song, He's a One-Way Jesus, and really, He is. It's only one way, and it's His way.
That's right.
That is so difficult for a mortal like me, or a fleshy fellow like me, to get that into their head or their heart. You know it by intellect, but if you really know something, you will then practice.
Amen.
You will practice.
Amen.
Listen to what I'm saying. You will practice what you know.
Amen.
So that tells me I don't know too much, is what it really tells me. But that's okay. God's still working on me.
Amen.
There's a little song.
Yes.
He's still working on me, and He's trying to work with me. We in this generation, I just heard a wonderful lecture this past week, few days, I can't remember, on the dysfunction of the human race. And I heard it over the internet, and I love the way that the man taught. I love the way that the man taught. Every word that proceeded out of his mouth was from the Word of God. He took his Bible, he went to the Bible stand, and he opened it up. And there's no teleprompters there, there's no anything there, but he has it in his heart. He has it in his heart. Did you know that you and I should have the Word of God so well in our heart that we can give a reasonable answer for the hope that lieth within? Last week I had some special people. They come every Saturday, I guess, I don't know. But anyway, they come, they make rounds on convincing the world that there is a Jesus, and that we should go this way, and we should, I mean, this is how it is. Well, I did invite them in because, number one, I wasn't really going to converse very long, but I said, okay, let me give you some information. So I proceeded to give them some information, and they listened. I'm not saying that they were open, but they listened. And I'm so glad that the Word of God can be planted in you.
Amen.
It becomes a part of your life so that you can give a reasonable answer.
Amen.
A reasonable answer.
Amen.
And, you know, just on the impromptu.
Right.
Meaning impromptu. Right now. on the sidewalk, at your house.
That's it.
In church, wherever you are, at a college lecture. All those things, you can give an impromptu speech.
That's right.
Regarding what God has done for you, and you're building on that rock again. And the rock is the revelation. Aren't you glad for the revelation tonight of Jesus Christ?
Yes.
There are many that read the script every day, and there's some nice stories. And the reason the stories are in there, they are really for our admonition. They are to give us an example. All the stories in the Old Testament. I'm in the 30th chapter of Genesis. I started reading there a little bit. And the reason I did, because I have a brother in Portland that they were studying that area. And I started reading there. And God can enlighten you by the stories that's already been told. It's an old story.
Yes, yes.
It's not a new song
amen.
That we sing. Mm-hmm. It came from Calvary. It came in before Calvary, the early church. Mm-hmm. The early church, which is the Old Testament. And no, that's the patriarch. Sorry, the early church is when Jesus died, or just before he died. Anyway, the patriarchs that started and got a revelation.
Amen.
They didn't have all the truth, but they had something to walk in the light. They had a little bit to walk, and they walked according to the Word of God. What they had, they walked according to that. And you and I are to do the same thing. It's really good to be in the house of the Lord tonight.
Amen.
It's really good to know that there's something stable about Him. This world changes from daylight to dark. There are so many changes around us that take place.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to hold to an unchanging hand.
Amen.
His law
Amen.
Is from here, from beginning through eternity or infinity.
Mm-hmm.
That's the law of God. How good it is to know that we have some of the law in our heart.
Amen.
And we can look up, because our redemption can draw nigh if we stand on the rock
Amen.
And the revelation that He has given us.
Praise God.